Hello? Okay, wait. Let me. No matter how many times I do this, I still seem to be strangely incompetent
Okay,
at
wait.
this. Okay, now I can actually
Let
see some
me.
shit.
No
Hello,
matter how
well.
many times I do this, I still seem to be strangely incompetent
Okay,
at
wait.
this.
Okay, now I
Let
can actually see
me.
some shit. Okay.
No
Hello,
matter how
well.
many times I do this, I still seem
Right.
to be
I'm gonna try and
strangely
do some
incompetent
innovative
at this.
stuff. Hey, good morning. Good morning. Hey, how's it going? I'm gonna go bring over the YouTube boys because it's kind of important for the sponsors. Never ever spoofed art. Yeah, it's actually true. Jesus Christ. Can I
Over
just
the you.
Right, let me pop out this chat because it's important. Let me pop out that chat. Let me pop out this chat because I'm recording on the second monitor. What I would like to do. You're late, we are unhappy. Wait. Cause I didn't know I could do this previously before. But I can launch many copies of OBS, which is quite nice. I'm gonna try to do something. We're gonna try multi-track drifting. Give me a sec. 'Cause what I would like to do to try and bring in people here. Give me a sec. Oh
When
fuck. Fuck.
when you hear about black people.
Fuck a D-Live.
What I would like to do.
All right. I would just like to bring in the YouTube boys. 'Cause I'm not sure if this works. I don't know if it's actually possible to stream on two services at the same time. So I'm going to try and bring in people from the YT. Okay. And next, oh God, all my information is fucking wrong. Okay, November 3rd. Give me a sec. Barbie Horse Adventures Mystery Ride. Okay. I will distribute the box when I have a chance. Give me a sec. What I would like to do here. Right. This will either crash the stream or it would actually go okay. Give me a chance. Would this actually work? Because what I'm doing right now is plugging into YT at the same time. Restream? Yeah, I know. This website is a little bit inconvenient sometimes. However, does this work? Does this actually work? Can I be heard? Can I be heard? Okay. We are successfully streaming to two services at the same time. Okay, now that I'm doing this actually, if I'm s okay, to anybody who's catching me on YT, I'm gonna put this whole stream on DLive. But what I would like to do, okay, if we're already on YouTube, I am gonna stream on Twitch at the same time as well. I think our bandwidth can take this. Give me a sec. And I know Twitch actually hates this. Okay, how would I do this? Hello. I apologize. I actually completely forgot how you're meant to actually stream. Channels. Private stream key. Oh yeah, if I actually accidentally dox my stream key, that is entirely my fault. You can stream on my Twitch, and you can have a great time with that. That's okay. Let's see, Twitch. Use my stream key. Give me that stream key. plot, plot. And stream there as well. Is that actually going to work? Okay. Okay. This is a mess. Okay. One is on YouTube. One is on Twitch. Main one is on DLive. Gimme. And where's the one that I'm just using for recording? Yeah. One sec. I just need to direct these videos. Stream archive VODs. So I can record over here. That's YT. This is... that's Twitch. This is on the live dashboard. Twitch, DLive, YT, multi-stream. Hell yeah. We're doing a multi-track drifting. Now... okay. That's YT. Where the hell is Twitch? Jesus. Does this work? Nani kudasai. Yeah, I know. Twitch does seem to have, like, actually a much better player. Okay. I got that. I got YT. I'm gonna put a goddamn timer. I have to put a goddamn timer. Anybody who is watching me on a much better platform than DLive, I will be migrating to DLive very, very shortly. Now, allow me to put on my goddamn intro videos, because I don't think that would violate all the... that probably will not violate the terms of service on all of those websites. Okay, let's see. Is that working? How do I play these? And since people were asking about this, where was I watching the old videos, which I use for the intros? It's just a channel called Just War Aesthetics on YouTube. Oh, or War Aesthetics for now. So, if you want those videos, just go to that channel. Okay. I need something that won't violate the terms of service while I get this goddamn stream set up. Okay, I'll see you soon.
Well, Seymour, I made it, despite your directions. Why is there smoke coming out of your oven, Seymour? I thought we were having steamed clams. You call hamburgers steamed hams? What region? Really? Well, I'm from Utica, and I've never heard anyone use the phrase steamed hams. I see. You know, these hamburgers are quite similar to the ones they have at Krusty Burger. For steamed hams. Yes, and you call them steamed hams despite the fact they are obvious to grill. Of course. Yes, I should be. Good Lord, what is happening in there? Aurora Borealis. At this time of year, at this time of day, in this part of the country, localized entirely within your kitchen. May I see it? Well, Seymour, you are an odd fellow, but I must say, you steam a good ham.
be like, my ass is heavy. Will be like,
Drake?
What?
Where's the...
It goes right there. See, I drew it with...
H-E-V.
You were supposed to...
Dude, I'm gonna.
Oh, really?
Yes.
So go get the...
Okay, I will. No!
Oh, stop!
Shit. Here we go again.
Oh, wait. I'll actually properly move to DLive, I think, after these ones. A little bit of a background lore. Did you know Flintstones had cigarette commercials in it back in the day? Because they actually had a lack of funding at some point, so they needed actually a sponsorship to keep them on the air. And you know where they got that goddamn sponsorship? Winston Cigarettes. So enjoy this history.
Yeah, I hate to see them work so hard.
Yeah, me too.
Let's go around back.
Well, we can't see them.
Gee, we ought to do something, Fred.
Okay.
How's about taking a nap?
Hey, I got a better idea. Let's take a Winston break.
That's it. Winston is the one filter cigarette that delivers flavor 20 times a pack. Winston's got that filter blend.
Yeah, Fred. Filter blend makes the big taste difference, and only Winston has it up front where it counts. Here, ahead of the pure white filter, Winston packs rich tobaccos specially selected and specially processed for good flavor in filter smoking.
Yeah, Bonnie, Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
The Flintstone has been brought to you by Winston. America's best-selling, best-tasting filter cigarette.
Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
The Flintstones, brought to you by Winston. America's best-selling, best-tasting filter cigarette.
Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
Hiya, Mr. Flintstone.
Greetings, Rocky, my boy. Pack of Winstons, please.
Oh, you like them Winston cigarettes, huh, Mr. Flintstone?
But of course, they really got something.
You bet your life. Folks who really enjoy smoking know it's what's up front that counts. And that's where Winston steps out ahead of the crowd with their exclusive filter blend. Choice golden tobaccos, specially selected and specially processed for filter smoking.
Hold it, hold it.
And what you mean?
What are you pitching Winston's at me for? You know I never smoke nothing else.
Just practicing, Mr. Flintstone. Everybody knows that.
Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
Yeah.
So See you soon, Rocky.
The Flintstones has been brought to you by Winston, America's best-selling, best-tasting filter cigarette.
Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
I hope you enjoyed that little history lesson. I think that might be the end of a goddamn little playlist I had. Okay, everybody who's on Twitch, the Twitch channel gotta die. The Twitch chat gotta die. Give me a sec. I forgot which one I'm streaming on which. Everybody on the YouTube stream, go to the DLive stream. Okay. Now, I gotta figure out which one's which, so I don't accidentally kill the DLive stream. Alright, Twitch stream, you're about to get neutered. Oh, okay, that's a timer, don't worry about that one. Okay, Twitch stream has been neutered. YouTube stream, they're next on the goddamn chopping block. I'm sorry about this, this has to happen. To make you feel better. Okay, hop on a DLive, because I need to inflate those sponsor numbers. Let me put on Pumped Up Kicks, just to make you feel better. Alright. You boys take care. See you on DLive. Sorry, I'm all fucking dying here. Sorry. Wait. Okay, we can actually finally do the goddamn stream. We got some very impressive numbers here, I'm sure. Wait, fuck. Wait, no, I can't swear on stream. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Winston's tastes good, like a cigarette should.
Right. Right. Let us continue with the content. I can actually see everybody's chat now. Let us go do some stuff. Now, do I have a protocol for today? Surprisingly, this must come like as a big, big goddamn surprise to you people. I'm still not used to this, and it takes me a long time to get used to all of this. We got a bunch of shitty DOS games. We got Might and Magic 6. I got Heroes of Might and Magic 3 working on windowed mode, so that should be good. Do you guys, because I showed you Winston's, do you know about Indian Antivirus? Because I can show you Indian Antivirus. It's amazing.
Oops, my system crashed. I lost my data, but I had an antivirus. Antivirus is not enough. You need Protegent, world's only antivirus with data recovery software. Think beyond antivirus. Think Protegent.
And I have another one. It's very, very innovative. It's the goddamn Protegent ad, but it's in free 60-degree rotation. I'll try and rotate this quick enough for everybody to see everything. Sorry, this is so fast to rotate. Here comes the ominous music.
You know what? Today, while going through browsing history of a computer, I saw some porn video links. Can you believe it?
Oh. Do you know who was the student who watched it?
No.
But we need to stop this kind of activity.
I know, but I don't know how to do it. Parents trust us so much for students' safety and their proper upbringing. But we are not able to do anything.
Hi, do you know me?
No, who are you?
I'm Proto. I just heard your problems and I have a single solution to all your problems.
What?
Yes, you need Protegent 360 to be installed in all your computers. It protects you from virus and internet threats with Protegent Total Security. It protects you from data theft with Port Locker and Data Leakage Prevention. It protects you from unethical activities by monitoring computer activity and sending the complete activity log on the assigned email ID.
Seriously?
Try Protegent 360 and experience yourself.
Rahul, come here with me. What you're doing is wrong. And you can legally be punished for this.
I'm sorry, teacher. Please don't tell it to anyone. I promise I'll never repeat this in my life.
Okay.
Thank you, Proto. You have saved me from going into a wrong direction.
Thank you, Proto. You helped me keeping parents' trust on us.
I hope you enjoyed that. It's time to think beyond antivirus. It's time to think Protojet. To be fair, I actually think I looked up smut on the school computers when I was really, really young. That was the age when I actually got this voice because my Adam's apple dropped very, very fucking early. So around 12 is actually when I had this current voice that I have now. And I managed to bullshit to like a senior student. Well, I probably did not convince her. I told her, because she said like, why are you looking up porn on the school computers? And I'm like, I'm selling it. I'm giving it away for people for money. I'm pretty sure that was not believable whatsoever. Do you know what the real goddamn reason was? The real goddamn reason was that when we moved into like a new country and I was in that school, we did not have internet wired at our home. That was fucking painful. So you know what I had to do? I went around with a little USB stick. And you know, those were like 128 megabytes back in the day. Plugged that stuff in, went onto porn site, downloaded 10 JPEGs that I liked. And that was my fat material. And I even know like the exact pictures. I would have to get this on the other screen. Give me a sec. Give me the. I can clip these. Do not worry. I think these are so old that I should be able to find them in the oldest section. Wow. Oh God, it's actually the exact pictures. Yeah, I needed. Oh yeah, this is a okay crop as long as it doesn't maximize. Yeah, it was a bunch of anime stuff. It was some good stuff, but then you know, oh God, I think that might be a butthole. Okay, it was a lot of Gardevoir stuff. So, that's what I had. So I could not, you know, I had to make my stuff count. You know, I had 30 pictures to fap to. Come on, they say. You know how they say, give a man a fish and you feed him for a day, teach a man to fish, he can feed himself for a lifetime. In the same way, give Seth an internet connection, please, and he won't bother school computers. I was a very, very bad student, by the way. I even skipped class a lot of that time. I think the first year that I got into the goddamn international school, the same place where I looked up porn on the goddamn computers, I did not go to class for something like three quarters of a year. I came to my chemistry class near the end of that year, and my chemistry teacher just had to ask me, wait, who are you? Like, what are you doing in my classroom? And I just had to say, I'm here for the exam. I'm here for the chemistry final. And, well, I became a much better student later on. I was not basically at my best time. Life is hard in London, Stan. Oh yeah, I also brought something over, because I know ASMR is all... Oh yeah, I passed that chemistry test. That was in the years when you didn't really have to study. This is before my ADD actually got to problem levels. At that time, I just thought I was a bad boy. Anyway, because ASMR is all the fire. Oh yeah, I love me some KMFDM. Because ASMR is all the fire. I've got a bunch of copper coins that I brought in a wallet, and I think I can jingle these around. Wait, I think, wait, is this too lewd? Wait. Oh. Oy vey. Shabos goy. If you want this falafel, it's gonna cost you £2.80. Wait, I need some. I wonder if I have. let me save that as a thing, and let me put that on the damn display. Sorry, this gets a little bit complicated with all the windows that I have. Give me. Because I remember we could put animated images. Give me a sec. Welcome to the Seth stream. Wi-Fi. Back from a hard day at my job at Goldstein Incorporated. We're solicitors for single mother divorce lawyers. Oh God. Oh God, my gastrointestinal reflux is mounting up. Oh no. I need these coins close to me. To be honest, I got a lot of coins. I think these add up to something like 2-3 pounds because they're all brown coins. Because the UK does many, many smart decisions. Now let's get rid of that little image that could be construed as anti-Semitic. Actually, no. Let's keep that image on. Can I just like rotate this a little bit? Because there's some cool filters I could put in. Let me do a scroll. Oh, okay. This is nice. I can tell a little bit of a story, cause this is story time with Seth. Oh, okay. Before I tell that story, I got another story. I recently was in talks with a bunch of people who wanted to offer me a rival sponsorship, and yeah, you may as well see my Vegas Pro. I think it's okay to see that. I'm working on the next review. It's about half done, and I was trying to get a better deal than the one I had, because I was gonna have ExpressVPN as my sponsor. And ExpressVPN, they eventually did pay my invoices after a long time. So I was hoping that maybe I'd just get somebody else in there as my sponsor, and hopefully, you know, actually just have an easier time. Okay, let's see. Let's go into my little Gmail. I hope I don't get doxxed just by doing this. I had a couple of nice people I talked to. And so they were the people who were representing NordVPN. But I could not take a job from them because NordVPN had their security leak recently. And they just said, we can't run any integration on November, because everybody's still paranoid. And you know, one of the funniest things, because they got me onto a call and they asked me a bunch of questions, and it was like this guy with his managers and everything like that, and I explained like why I would kind of go rogue and take NordVPN over ExpressVPN, and then the manager came in. He's like, yeah, this sounds really good, Seth. I just want to make sure that we're all aligned and on the same page. I just want to ask you a little bit of a question, because I looked at some of your content. Can you explain to me why there's thumbnails of Joseph Kony in your content? Now, I did not really understand, and I was like, this is a guy who's quite liberal, because of course they're coming from California and stuff.
Hey.
But I don't think Joseph Kony looks like Agutu Mbike in any way. That is probably the most racist thing I've actually heard in my life. And I had to explain to them, actually, no, it's not Joseph Kony. It's this guy who's a UN peacekeeper in the Democratic Republic of Congo. And he's still kind of doing his job, even though there's no funding and there's no money, because he just wants to keep his homeland more or less safe as he possibly can be. And then they just went silent. I don't understand what those people were after. Yeah, that's actually like a crazy thing. That's a crazy thing that I find with those people. You know, the only times in my life when somebody just straight up comes to you and says, oh, you're a racist and something like that, it's people from like California. And you know, I know a little bit about California, and I know they're extremely segregated. So they could say all this stuff about, oh, you know, I love black people. I'm down with the blacks. Haha, my fellow urban, my fellow African American, my fellow melanated man. But they live in completely different neighborhoods. So they never cross goddamn neighborhoods. They never interact with black people. And then they will have all this audacity to say that, oh, they're not the racists. Anyway, I'll tell you another story, because this is why I actually had the Jew gif here. Long ago, because this Morrowind review has been up for a long time. My Morrowind review actually got copyright striked long, long ago. And it was copyright striked by not a company. It was actually copyright strike by somebody with their real name. And that person, I did not know who that was, so I started like digging around, like maybe we can come to like an agreement. Maybe I took like some art and didn't give credit for it. So I went over and researched. Turned out she was from Tumblr. She was a Polish lesbian living in Australia. And I wrote to her just like a polite little DM and so on. So yeah, you know, I understand if like I put your art in there by accident. Just tell me what your art is. I can either clip it out or I can just, you know, send you some money your way. Because, you know, I see your work on your Patreon and stuff. So let's get to an agreement. She responded. And she responded with every name in the book. She called me a racist. She called me everything. She basically hated my content. She also hated the Merchants Guild because she said, quote unquote, the little funny Jew rubbing hands meme is absolutely anti-Semitic. And I told this woman, but I'm a Jew. I can understand if you think some of the content is grating, but I am literally a kike. I'm literally a kike, and we literally lost property because we were kikes on the wrong side of a border between Russia and Germany. And she said, well, just being Jewish doesn't mean you can make anti-Semitic comments. Whoa. I don't fucking know about this person, and so apparently she was just completely unreasonable, and so I had to like ask YouTube what can I do about this because she essentially made a copyright strike. Now, keep in mind, penniless Tumblr lesbian who just hates everything about me, my entire persona, everything that I am, all of my ethos, and everybody who's surrounded with me. And so I actually looked this up. Instead of dealing with her directly, you can actually start a process. If you have a copyright claim, you can make a counterclaim. You know what a counterclaim is? A counterclaim is the beginning of a goddamn legal process. So I just wrote to her, hey, I sent back a counterclaim. You've got something like 28 days to basically put this to court. Because I've made the counterclaim. I put my actual name, my real address, all the plaintiff details. Hell yeah, let's go fight this in civil court. And I did this at the time when I was still doing this stuff part-time in when I was finishing university. So I actually had almost no money. But I knew I had just enough savings to fight the court case. And I asked a copyright lawyer, how much of a case does she have? And he asked me, so could you show me her work? Could you show me the stuff that she said you stole from her? By the way, ignore all this dog mom hentai. So I will actually find, I think it's a dot gif in here. Should be a dot gif. Oh yeah. She made a copyright claim on this two-frame animation, right? And I asked the lawyer, so does she have like a solid ground for a legal case? And he told me back, is it a registered trademark or copyright? Like at a U.S. House of Copyright Law? No, I searched it up. Okay, well, another thing, it's video game fan art, so you inherently don't own that. So I went ahead, made this counterclaim. I'm basically putting her, it's all in her field. Either she has to go to court, and I'm telling her, I'm warning her, don't go to court, because if you lose the case, you have to pay my court fees as well. And you know what? She screamed. She called me every name in the book again. And then she released the claim, and the video was back. Because it turned out, whenever money starts being involved in this and actually being called into question and accountable for your stuff, she fizzled out. She just ran. She just ran. Apparently, a bunch of people also found her Tumblr, and they were also harassing her. And yeah, that was the end of that story. That was my first experience with an almost court case. yeah, I think that's the gist of that story. But I have no antipathy to the LGBT or anything like that. They are absolutely fine and nice people, because there's just a very tiny minority that tries to start shit. Anyway, can I show some of our schedule today? I'm a show you some of the stuff that we got, because I've been finding a bunch of terrible games. And we can actually check them out. I'd like to start off with one which has no audio. So let me remove that image. Let me show you boys. Let me show you Pocahontas. Defend is like an extra shell for DOSBox, and it can actually just let you easily launch games. Oh yeah, welcome to Pocahontas. If you are not hearing any sounds, there's a reason for that, because there are no sounds. I have never figured out how to get sound working in this goddamn game, so I wanted to make my own supplementary audio. For all of this stuff. Oh, let me just close this crap. So, this game is going to be very short, by the way, because all I had is... Oh, Jesus Christ. Can't believe I did this. Don't worry. I know even the timestamp for this shit, so... Let's do a speed run of Pocahontas really, really quickly.
Exorcist exterminate the weak. Execution level next. No way to explain it. I'm XXX, bitch, triple X rated.
Okay. And that's all I had of that goddamn game. That was a really goddamn terrible one. Okay, here's one that's really interesting. We can actually ask the chat for this stuff. Welcome to very early adult games. So, do you know what DRM was back in the day? Also, you must be 21 to play this program. This is Sextrus. To verify your age, please answer three simple questions. Who sang Sergeant Pepper? Which company does Bill Gates boss? IBM? Wait, what? How was your first time? I'll put four. None of your business. Oh yeah, so it closes, because we answered Bill Gates wrong. Okay, Beatles. Which company does Bill Gates? And, hell yeah, boys! Welcome to Sextrus! Hell yeah! Oh yeah! Oh, wait, oh, that's a titty! No. Ah! No! I need some censorship here. I need some images to hide this. Give me a sec. This is an appropriate image to censor all this stuff. Okay. How bad does Sextra still look? Wait, what have I done to it? Wait, that's it? Wait, Sextra's actually closed. Are you kidding me? Oh, it actually closed. Great. Amazing. Right. So Sextrus is a high-quality game. Now, I'll also show you one which is absolutely goddamn terrible. I found this. 1990, Hanna-Barbera Productions. Welcome to Freddy Flintstone. Now, the biggest question here is, collect 100 Winstons. Who are we going to play as Fred or Bonnie? Fred or Bonnie, are you going to do two players? But if it's two players, who gets to be Bonnie? This game is a piece of goddamn shit. I wonder if I can put Fred on loop, screaming Wilma. Can I just loop this? YouTube looper. Yes. Perfect.
Wilma! Wilma!
Okay, this is great.
Wilma!
Stop that! Okay.
Wilma!
Why can't I stop? Why can't I stop?
Wilma! Wilma!
And that's the whole goddamn game.
Wilma!
Oh, by the way.
Wilma! 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 Wilma!
I
The controls here are absolutely insane. I think it says, like, page down and all of this crap like that to do actions. Come on, Fred. You can do this. Oh, Jesus. Oh, wow. What? Oh, it works like Mario. I can't believe this. Again, I can't actually believe this. Okay. I have... Okay, Sextrus. What else did I find? There's Asterix and Obelisk, but it's not actually that great. I got Strip Poker Deluxe. So you can get some real titillating stuff. One sec. Dios míos. I hope this isn't so goddamn loud. Anyway, we're gonna play some strip poker. Also, if you guys can't speak Spanish, I'm sorry. Anyway, I have some stuff from this girl that I've already been doing strip poker stuff for. Let me inform you. Each time I click on a menu, it's gonna kind of freeze up. So each time a girl shows up, this actually happens. Yeah, boy. Okay, if you guys don't know how to play poker, get the hell out of here. Okay, let's, wait, do we even actually have a good pair here? Okay, 9, 10. Igualo. Now I'm hoping for a good match. Oh, this is terrible. This is actually terrible. I pass. Ooh. What does Irsa do, actually? Hoy, perdona. Yo no quiera. Oh, that's a good one. That's a very, very good one. So the whole idea is, when women run out of money, they gotta show you boobies. And this is exactly what we're gonna do here. We're gonna manipulate this woman into showing us boobies. Fin descarte. Oh! A free pair and a double. That's good. That's real good. I wanna rob her. I am straight up wanting to rob her immediately. I mean, unless she's got, like, something like a straight or a royal. Tu gamas. Esque seque. Si siempre gano yo, te abueres. Look how much money we get. Wait. I might be doing this really, really badly. I might make a very bad decision here. So please don't judge me. Ah, it's, okay, that's not too bad, actually. I think a two pair might actually do it. Yeah, boy! Oh, yeah, boy. Yeah, boy! I know. Okay. Wait, this is another fantastic one. I mean, in terms of... G!
Jesus! Oh my god, she actually did it goddamn well. One second. She actually got something really goddamn good. I can't believe this. Give me a sec. Trips beat dubs. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna try and go for high pairs now. Yeah, she got a lot of goddamn good money. That makes me a lot further away from getting her boobies. Obvies are terrible. Yeah, she would have actually won there. No! I don't like it at all. I don't like this at all. We're going back to the menu. We are gonna... Listen. So, I don't like Nadia. I think Nadia's pretty ugly. Young. Right. I don't like Nadia. We've got Paula, but we've also got Caddy. Let's play her intro. Gatti es un chica, giovane e atrevida, que no posio cumpleos de ningún tipo, y menos para jugar a excitantes y entretenadas partidas de strip poker. Dios mío, Jesus Cristo. We need these goddamn pairs. Let's hope for the best, boys. These are not good pairs. Menos mal que te he dejado ganar, porque si no, a lo mejor te retiras. Wait. Oh, we could actually get cards in order now. We could actually get a straight here. I'm sorry. Of many languages that I've spent time with, I have not spent any time with Spanish or French. Let's be gambling men. Let's be some goddamn gambling men here. Ooh. Okay. Let's. I mean, a two pair is not that great. A este paso no volveré a jugar más contigo. Oh. We're getting close. We're getting close, boys. A nine pair. Okay, fuck it, let's go. Igualo. Let's see what we could possibly get here. We could try and ride the wave. Maybe we'll get another eight. No. This is not fantastic, honestly. Oh my god! Te gane y no pretendas que me arrepienta. En semana la tata. Right. Clearly it was not working out between me and the poker. Let me show you a game that's a bit easier to understand. I hope the audio actually plays here. Yeah, we're gonna also start Princess Maker a little bit later on. So, this is a cracked copy. I don't actually have to enter all of this stuff in. I remember the Lion King copyright stuff is just, you just enter Simba each time. I think if you enter any letter, it works. Please enjoy some quality Aladdin. Oh, no. Everybody knows the plot of Aladdin. It's time to go. Oh yeah, we have to actually increase the cycle speed of this game. I actually hope this is not too loud. Let me put on the mixer. Ugh. Please, DOSBox. And you might think to yourself, well, a sword should be much mightier than an apple, right? Incorrect. Apples are much more reliable than swords. And of course, as we as we know, the main cause of death in slums are pots being rained on you. Apples are the most effective way of dealing with all of your problems. Oh, Jesus Christ! Yeah, there's kind of a delay on inputs in this game, so it's gonna feel a bit floaty. This is actually a decently hard game as well. This was the Metal Slug of its time. Okay, that doesn't work. I think I can hold down, actually, the apple button. Ah! Is he dead? Is he dead? Just keep raining apples on him. Oh, Jesus Christ, not again. One sec. I'm not the best man at platforming, so please have some patience. Ah! God damn it. I'll try and do it right this time. Give me a sec. Oh, whoops.
I'll just finish one level for you, and I'll show you some of her stuff. Give me a sec. When you have a ranged weapon available to you, there's no use using a melee weapon instead. Wait, can I? Oh, I can do this. Yeah. Get out of here. Always bet on apples, boys. Whoops. Ugh. Let's see. I swear to God. Oh, there's something very important for us to get. God damn it. Okay, got it. Fantastic. Oh, yeah. We've got merchants in this game, by the way. So, we got some money. We can either get an extra life or a free wish. I'm gonna go for the life. Thank you, fellow merchant. All right. We got a level. Oh, and then you get to gamble, by the way. Of course, if you select a sultan, or the vizier, It's gonna end, but then you can just keep gambling if you don't. Oh, Jesus. And because we collected a thing, we can actually now play as Abu. Enjoy. This is incredibly stressful, by the way.
Ah!
Okay, one more level. Swear to God, my hitbox. This is clearly not balanced. Oh, I swear to God. Yeah, the soundtrack is actually absolutely sick. Ah, I swear to God. It just does not latch on. Give me a sec. Okay, yeah. Ah! This is the original Assassin's Creed of its time. Give me a sec. Okay, apologies about that. Ah!
I wonder if there's a version of Darkside Phil that only complains about really vintage games and so on. Just keeps complaining about, like, really faulty inputs on goddamn DOS games. True hero of his time. Okay. This is a very perilous path. Sorry, Yago. It's just the way the cookie crumbles. Are you kidding me? One sec, we need to get this thingy. I don't know what that thingy does, but we still need it. Ah! Goddamn snakes. I swear to God. Oh yeah, a little checkpoint at least. Oh yeah, I really much appreciate that there's a men's, a women's, and a genie's bathroom. They were actually very accepting of trans rights back then. Wait. Oh, there's another one here. I managed to be able to, like, keep doing this non-stop. Okay, I think that's enough of showing off Aladdin. What else did I actually find here? Also, by the way, unfortunately, Dune 2000 does not actually work here. And Princess Maker is an interesting game. It's an interesting game, but it will take, like, a long time to actually play. I'll tell you what. We still have, like, a bunch of shit to actually cover. So, maybe I can introduce the boys to Heroes of Might and Magic 3 after not playing it for so long. We'll just play African Raiders. We'll play African Raiders for non-stop after this. Let me. I need to actually have a piss. Give me a sec. I'll put on Protogen circulation. I'll be right back. One sec. Don't play this.
Give me a sec.
Apologies, my fridge is right next to my computer. I think my bananas have all rotten. Jesus Christ. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, I don't think this is safe to eat. This is not actually safe to eat. I apologize. I was trying to look for food, but my fridge only has like kind of rotten bananas. I'm not eating it. I already ate like tainted berries not too long ago. Yeah, it's good for immunity, but wait. Okay, let's try. People see them goddamn bookmarks way too damn fast. Right, let's actually try and play Here's My Magic Free. I'm actually gonna check if this will look okay on the stream. One sec. It's gonna be complaining about Windows features. Okay, let me try and let me reset the transform. Let me put it nicely scaled. Nunny, can I just do this like that? Yeah. All right, fantastic. Oh god, I need to make sure that it's not going to be too loud. Let me put on my mixer. Fuck. Nope, that's not what I wanted. Let me put that to 10. Oh no, I've actually never even played with the HD mod. So I'm entirely out of practice. I'm entirely out of practice about this game. So if you'd like, let's see. Wait, we have a map called Jihad? All of your six neighbors have declared a jihad against you and each other. What's a very good one? I'm just looking for the maps which have 8 players. Oh, Free For All is actually fine. Oh, we could actually go for Jihad if you want. I think that might be... Wait. Okay. So, I can play any race. If you want to vote for a race, just put it in the chat. I'll play the race that you want. Please play Fortress? Okay, well, Fortress gives us some limited options for actually good heroes. Where is he? Where are you? Ah, there you are, Tazar. Wait, let's see all the votes here. That's a lot of votes for Necro, honestly. That's a lot of votes for Necro. Let's see who we gonna play. Honestly, like Aislinn should be fine, right? Welcome to the fast paced world of playing goddamn Necros. Yeah, Necro would be terrible for this map. Give me a sec. Where's Jihad? Actually, Fortress might be okay for a map like that. Local man asks chat for opinions, flakes out, and actually goes back on his original thought. Anyway, let's go maximize our troop count. Oh, thank you. Mr. Beastmaster here can go scout out for us. Wait, how tiny is this map? This is actually gonna be very, very fast-paced. We need to hit Wyvern Nest as quickly as possible. Fortress. And thank you, Merchant Number One, for the Ninja Genie. I don't know how much that is, but thank you. Anyway. We need to rapidly expand. I think we need to just take an enemy's town over extremely fast. Right. Oh yeah, we need to actually open up the chest after this. Welcome to Tactical. I can make it louder. I hope this is actually an okay volume. Top tier tactical gameplay. Is that a one-way? Good God, that's a one-way. Let's see how quickly we get bum-rushed by our enemies. Can we get Wyvern Nest? Oh, yeah, boy, we got Wyvern Nest. We need to rapidly push our advantage, because otherwise Fortress will actually fall off if we don't use their rush tactics. These are not optimal decisions. Okay, we actually lost two gnolls. I think I may as well just quit this goddamn game right now. There's no coming back from that. Well, we need to find a hero prism, and we can recruit Osama bin Laden. This is correct. Osama bin Laden's only a campaign hero. He's a campaign hero, he's got a racial bonus, that he's getting CIA training. Which means sharpshooters train up faster. Wait. This place is absolutely fucked. I need to check actually where these gates go. It goes no- oh. Well, interesting. Now, we need a little bit of an economy to actually keep our war machine going. This is a terrible map. I must say, this is a goddamn terrible map. Our only options right now are to take other people's places. Wait, what does that sign say? Proceed to cover of darkness. Oh. Oh. Okay, we will... Thank you for the diamond, Kiki. Thank you for the pumpkins. What the hell is a pumpkin? Take the imp's lunch money.
Oh, these are actually a fair bit tougher. I think. Oh. Just out of range. The ultimate tactic is to just avoid losing all your troops and just keep rapidly advancing. Oh, we have terrible resource management. May as well just get a citadel. What kind of goddamn place is this? We are actually getting okay numbers and so on. Oh boy. Got a Ring of Vitality, which is very good for low level units. We got a Crest of Valor, which is very good for us in general. But we are never upgrading that goddamn Null Hut. Because we need to focus on trying to get Wyvern Monarchs. That will help us a great deal. In the meantime, we could get a castle. This is terrible. This is actually a terrible map for all of us. Well, we're not going to get anything else out of it anyway. Asterios Kalkanos abuses women. Wait, what is happening to the Null Hut? I think they just add another little hut to the Null Hut. That counts as an upgraded Null Hut. Let's see how our enemies are doing. Our enemies are not doing too great. That's good. Because our overall hope is to just get our economy going, and then we will be more or less okay. Although, honestly, we would need... Wait, these are actually very low numbers. I assumed the numbers would be much higher. Okay, let's grab these. Zeto. That's another one way. I've never actually done this goddamn map. So I'm very sorry that I'm learning this very slowly. We did not manage to have a castle in the first week, which is very unfortunate for us. But hell, let's try this. Merchant just linked a cute tiny teen sex. A good porn actress, though. Oh, this is not a very good position whatsoever. Why did I even move forward? Oh yeah, because they're not upgraded, they're not actually that scary. Our goddamn gnolls! Four brave men lost their lives. But we won't cry for them. We'll just remember their sacrifice for later. Are you kidding me? Wait, is that a two-way? Finally. This map is so scuffed.
I think the whole idea is you can flank into their territory by taking all these one-way routes. So I think that's what we actually have to try and do. And we need to do that rapidly before we fuck up. Now, the main thing is to get those wyverns and continue with business as usual. Uh-oh. Nani more. I'll show you a pro gamer strategy. Let me show you his pro gamer strategy. Alright, I surrender. Bye. Our guy is back in town. Unfortunately, that was really, really stupid because that replaced a hero that I could instantly buy and give myself more troops. Right. I don't even know if these forces are enough to actually invade. I'll be honest here, there's not many good winning moves in this goddamn map. So we're gonna just go balls to the wall here. Oh. This might be harder than I anticipated. Okay, these ones will fuck us up if we leave them alone. Worry not, the rest of the imps are not as bad. Okay, never mind, they have high morale, it's actually quite a bit worse. I can't believe this. I hate goddamn imps. Oh, great! Yeah, you can have more! You can have more morale. Fuck that. Alright, well. Another man dead because of my mistakes. We better get some goddamn good money here. Oh, expert armorer, though. Ooh, baby. We can actually make our wyvern monarchs very soon. Oh. Who convinced me to play this map? Who the fuck convinced me to play this goddamn map? I'm not even mad at the people who convinced me to play it. I listened to it. Alright, at least we have a decent economy. Okay, great. Let's dive right in there. Let's hope for the best here. Okay, it's a 4 damage ballista. That's not too bad, honestly. Oh, Jesus. My...
Let's see what we can do here. Ooh. We need to just keep rapidly preserving our wyverns. This is why I'm not actually putting them in very dangerous situations, because losing the wyverns is gonna hurt me a lot more than any of the lower stacks. Oh, he fled! What a little piece of shit! Fuck that! Fuck that! Actually fucking angry. Here. Christian, you're gonna go get like a little image meme made of you, fucking retard. Add text. Jared, add text. Add text. Okay, can I scale that up? Nice. Retard. Oh yeah, sorry, I'm not meant to swear, actually. If we could just get somebody to hold the gates here. That would be very, very nice, but we don't have anybody to hold the gates. We will get a castle soon enough. Maybe if we get lucky, we can get it before the end of this week. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. We probably will actually die if we do this one. Give me a sec. I forgot how many you actually have in this place. Nope, that's death. That's death. That's actually death. Well, I can actually fight this fruit if you'd like to see it. But I think my net profit here is very, very limited. No. Nope. Bye. I just forgot how many dragonflies. It could be like a. It could be kind of a variance. It depends on how many wyverns it will give you as a reward. I swear to God, I need to take some guys. I need to take some guy's place, like immediately, right now. Okay, our resources have been plundered. There's some faggot here with a lot of units. Wait, does everybody go to this point? Are you kidding me? This is actually just like a mosh pit right now. Okay, I have to get out of here. I have to get out of here and invade some guy's place, like, rapidly. Nope. No castle, no high unit production. Okay. I think by the amount of time that I've spent, this is nearly impossible. Is this a castle? Well, it has one tower. Okay, well, fuck it. Let's try. Teal's been vanquished. Are you kidding me? Okay, we're just gonna Naruto run into this base. Yeah, I should actually, this is a very correct thing. I need one stacks for baiting people out.
make a couple of my one stacks. If I can just keep my... Yeah, that should be fine. That should be... this should be okay. And put it into tight formation. So, what does he have left in his place? He has a lot left in his place. God damn. So why did he leave? He also left through a one-way exit. So, he's not coming back. Like, he's somewhere here now. I'm just gonna chill here, then. You know what we do need, though? We need wood. Wood would be quite nice. Let's fuck up these halflings, though. Oh, nice. Good job, fucking Frodo. Nope. Okay, alright, we're gonna chill here. We can mix two different alignments without any kind of, morale penalty. But for now, we can just chill here. Might actually get a spell book. Yeah, it's okay spells. What else can we get? Like, a capital would be nice here, if I don't get my ass shafted and invaded very short term. Huh. Well, it does not seem like Brown can get back to me anymore, because of their poor choices. Tell you what, I don't want to take a chance and actually lose this town and then have to defend it with walls. Attack it with goddamn walls. Oh, hello, Miranda. Ooh, actually, wait, somebody actually trained this boy up. Now, gremlins are quite nice to us. I can just take these. Sorry, we're splitting up the stacks, so in case he actually gets attacked, he's completely fine. Come on. He needs to take our resource points. Because I'm not sure... Oh, so that's where it would have gone. I just want to make sure that Brown doesn't get their place back while I'm scouting around. This is why I'm being incredibly cautious right now. Orange has been vanquished. We continue. We got a capital. We need to hold on to this capital. Oh, right. Sorry. I need to remove this whole fake cuck thing on screen. I'm very sorry about that. I'll put something else in there later on. There will be no upscaling here. Cliff of Gallantry. Oh, we have extremely high morale now. So it looks like Brown is not a threat in the immediate moment. Let's hope for the best. Yeah, this map is actually okay, after you kill somebody. Before that point, it's a little bit painful. What I'm kind of concerned about as well is, we could actually return back like that. Give me un memento. Oh, hell yeah, pixies. So now that our place is actually getting upgraded, we can actually get our other unit production dwellings. Because the main thing we want a lot of wyvern production. Wyverns are going to help us take all of our towns. Now, Tazar, we need to... Wait, that place is no good, actually. There's no reason to go there. Only pain. Do we use crystals? I think Conflux also uses mercury. I think it's a mercury town. Alright, so I'm just gonna return Tazar back to his place. And this guy can become our dedicated Conflux hero. Altar of Fault would be good. Oh, we might not get all this stuff in time. We need to start ramping up our production rapidly. Gorgons are also fantastic, but you know a big problem with Fortress? The goddamn material costs. Everything costs wood. Everything costs stone. But you need a lot more wood than you need stone. But it's cheaper for us to get basilisks. Oh, great. He's coming back. He's coming back for his place. Right. You know what this means? This means we need to, we need a setup for war, because if he does not get that place back, he's going to be forced into attacking us, by the way. Does this dwelling have, like, anything impressive? How's my morale? I can take another type of unit. So normally, if you mix three different units, you get a morale hit. Oh, doesn't count. Okay. Okay, Astral can just go chill here. Because he just needs to live. We can't get anything very impressive. We can get a castle. A castle will actually increase our defense massively. And we can get Earth Elementals just to tank the damage. So that... We should live. We should live. Oh, he ran away. He's actually gonna die if he doesn't take this castle. As I noted on the units. Wait. Oh yeah. Troops of free alignments. Sorry about that. I have a lot of wood for you, Mr. Seth. Okay, while this map is fine and dandy, I'm gonna save that up. Because we are actually getting close to the time where I'm actually meant to suspend the stream. But we got something like, I don't know, 10-15 minutes. So, I haven't shown you guys properly Might and Magic 7, have I? Huh. I think I could show you a little bit of stuff. Oh god! Three. Oh yeah, I need to open the apple box. Sorry about that. Give me a sec. Oh, there it is. Collectivism coming in right now. I accidentally added lemons to the chest. I don't know when this is actually about to be distributed. It has a really big time delay. Is that it? Come on. Oh yeah, it's been distributed. Please enjoy. Also, thank you for the donations. I try not to say it too much, just to not distract people. Alright, fantastic. Fantastico. I've got my magic kind of actually scaled up, so I can show you. Wait. What have I done? What have I actually done? Oh, there. This is fine as a party.
Hear ye, hear ye. The Emerald Island scavenger hunt is about to begin. The list of objects has been given to all contestants. As you know, the winners of the contest will be awarded title to Castle Harmony and the surrounding lands. Be careful. Emerald Island can be dangerous. Last night, three contestants disappeared, and we are concerned for their safety. During the contest, please be on the lookout for our missing contestants. If you find a piece of equipment in the woods, return at once with a clue. It may save their lives. In rumors that some kind of monster is loose on the island and may be hiding in one of the caves. If you see a cave you are unfamiliar with, don't go into it. Send someone back to town and the guards will conduct a search for you. We don't want anyone else to get hurt. And one more thing. We have reports that the monster may be a dragon. If you see it, run for your lives.
Hey, welcome to Might Magic 7. What's up? It's actually got one of my favorite musics, so you're gonna go listen to that on the full volume, and then I'll tell you some cool stuff.
I learned it!
This should be useful. This should be useful.
Ah, excellent.
One sec. Oh, this is very smooth compared to My Magic 6. They did a couple of upgrades and so on. And actually the game just runs. Okay, this is our guide. We tell her to shut up. Alright, let's just save a game there. So, I don't really have time to go through all of this stuff. So, to just clarify, you have to do a treasure hunt, then you get given a really bad piece of property, a really bad piece of land, because the actual guy wants to get rid of that property because it's very volatile. However, This initial part of the game is quite difficult. It's very, very tough. However, if you'll notice, there's a lot of people walking around town. Okay, now I can actually turn down all this stuff.
Thank you very much.
What? Does this not scale? What? What is the sound based on? I could put all these to nothing. It must be playing externally from something. So, we got a lot of people in town here. And there's one man in town. Very, very interesting. Mr. Malwick, he gives you a proposal. You can either accept a wand from him or decline it. If you accept this wand, he actually blackmails you later on to collect on that debt. If you don't want to go through that, because essentially his mercenaries will attack your actual keep and so on, you can make Mr. Malwick here have an accident. And I'll show you exactly how to do that. Sorry, I just gotta set these as the spells. So, we're gonna be... If you can look at the right side of the map, that's our mini-map. We are gonna be herding. We are gonna be herding a lot of goddamn dragonflies. And what is the purpose of these dragonflies? Well, we don't have to fight them. That's a bit dangerous. We're gonna make sure the town guard gets occupied by them. And then Mr. Malwick here... Oh, come here, Mr. Malwick. Don't run too far. Okay, we're just gonna make sure Mr. Malwick stays here. And this guard is doing fine, by the way. Oh no. Oh no. The guard could not actually keep his shit together. Now I'll show you. Mr. Malwick, just stay here. Stay comfortably seated. Oh, he's taking damage. Oh, yep, yeah, fantastic. So... We've actually killed Mr. Malwick. Well, we haven't killed him. We've extracted some stuff from him. Now, Mr. Malwick gives us a very goddamn nice wand. By the way, let's loot all of these townspeople that have died. Sorry, our combat abilities with the default party are terrible. Oh no, this woman died. She was a cook. Rest in peace. Oh, look. I guess those other people didn't drink from this fountain. Because they met an unlucky end. Oh, what? Controls. Yeah, always walk, of course. We looted that guard, we got some good money. Now let me show you some real quick stuff. These dragonflies will not be as spooky in a second. Okay. So we've actually also got a cannon here we can fire. I don't know what the purpose of this is, but hey. These are also some contestants which you can get some stuff off. I wish Brett knew how to make a red potion. Good God. Is this technology even invented at this point? You want a blue potion? I know how to make a blue potion, but not a red one. We don't need him for now. So now we've got Day of the Gods on us. We can actually do quite a lot of stuff. And let me show you something real nice. Okay. So normally we would have a lot of trouble with all these dragonflies. Okay, sorry. This is not a very good way to do things. Oh, sorry, everybody's tired now because we put haste on them. That was a bad idea. We can keep swapping out this wand. And we can do this. And we can essentially handle all of the goddamn early game just by abusing that goddamn wand. And if you want your cost efficiency, you should do it very deep into a crowd. Bring on a bigger challenge. Okay, let me try and herd these. Oh no. You know, I think it's actually a good ending for the stream to see, like, what happens if you try and fire this thing point blank? Because a fireball is pretty strong.
Though you have been defeated, death is not your fate today. Return now to the land of the living. You have much work still to do.
I don't know why death sounds like Lego Yoda, actually. But wait. You know, you can actually keep doing this repeatedly. I'll show you.
Though you have been defeated, death is not your fate today.
Wait. Thing is, what I'm very interested in... Because I murdered a townsperson with that fireball. And I'm wondering if this is a very valid way to actually complete the game. Give me a sec. I'll just show one thing. Because there's a... We need a little bit of mana.
Cock and ball torture. CBT, your fate is...
Right. I just want to check if we die as a result of this fireball, will everybody actually be pissed at us?
It doesn't even hurt,
but I need it fixed.
So, we murdered this woman because we get a loot out of it. A loot is one of the things we need from the treasure hunt. So, yeah, boys, we're moving up there. So all the townspeople do get hostile to you, but I... Oh yeah, one guard actually saw this. Unfortunately, they also zigzag, which makes it very hard to actually catch them with a goddamn fireball.
We do not need them.
Alright, okay, this happened.
Though you have been defeated.
Wait, what happens now? Oh, everybody becomes normal, actually. If you die, it resets all your, it resets that everybody's pissed at you. I wonder if a guard is still... I wonder if a guard is still injured, actually. Hello? Oh, no. He's healed up. Okay, how do we end this stream? Okay, I just want to save us in advance. I want to save us in advance to the DLive sponsors. This is not a hate crime.
Though you have been defeated, death is not your fate today. Return now to the land of the living.
I wonder if that gypsy is dead. Let me show you one more thing that you can do in this game before I have to stop the stream. Oh, by the way, you can also jump in this one. We need a little bit of mana. They added a shout command to actually get townspeople out of your way. Oh, it actually works on everybody. Somehow you can just shout at the town guard and he'll listen to you.
Go! Go!
Get away! Get away! Get away!
I wonder how they sound if it's different people.
I'm the one you pick me.
if you want the smoker's cough, Goblin GF, this is it.
You have to choose me.
Choose me.
You have to choose me.
I'm your man. Pick me. You want to ride high? Ride with me.
How about me?
I won't let you down.
How about me?
Pick me.
Come on, pick me.
Choose me.
Come on, pick me.
By the way, this elf, whenever he gets disease, he automatically just gets like teenage acne. I have no idea why. Sorry, we gotta... I have to distribute these skill points just so I can show you her shouts. Choose me. Okay, give him some luck. Okay. Two are off. Okay, what's their shouts like?
Get away! Get away! Get away!
Can I put it to max?
Thank you very much.
Get away!
Move! 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 Move!
You basically just lead a hoe into the ocean. She has nowhere to go. This is how life under oppression, under patriarchy works.
Move!
Get out! Move! Get out! Move! Get out of the way!
Just back off! Just back off! Just back off!
Okay. Yeah, I think to end the stream, I'm just gonna drown. Do you know how you drown? You jump, you go into the water.
Is that supposed to hurt? Just a scratch. Is that supposed to hurt? Just a scratch. Is that supposed to hurt? Is that supposed to hurt? Is that supposed to hurt? Is that supposed to hurt?
That barely hurts.
Is that supposed to hurt?
That barely hurts.
Is that supposed to hurt? Is that supposed to hurt?
Okay. There's my specialist knowledge of fucking my Magic 7. This stream has been a mess. I wish I actually planned stuff a little bit better. I'm slowly getting more competent at this, but that's my belief. That's not reflected in reality. So, thanks for sticking around. This is what the... Okay, we had 16, 20, 27, free. This is the fourth stream. After the next stream, technically, DLive should fulfill their part of the bargain, and we should get our hentai money. Will they actually pay? Who knows? but hopefully they do. Anyway, what's a very nice ending for this goddamn stream? I shall see you boys in a week, and hopefully we have some stuff to do. And maybe I can also bring some people over. Maybe not the next stream, maybe a stream after that. I did go through the idea or the suggestion of bringing a couple of people in, and then we do a reading of some hentai shit and so on. Whatever you like. So until then, please have a good night. Have a good morning, whatever time zone it is. Please have a wonderful day, and look after yourselves. So, take care. Mwah.